Hi. You may be wondering what happened between this last episode and this. Well, the last episode was from a live stream, and some of the footage kind of didn't go so well. Nothing to worry about. I didn't do too much, anything too interesting in it. I traveled over to Evergreen Mills, and I kind of maybe sort of got a bobblehead. It's fine. It only increased my barter by 10. And nothing drastic, and I had this new the terrible shotgun, which is a very powerful shotgun. That I probably won't be using for some time. Maybe, I don't know. That also I did traveling. You see I left a trail of markers leading up to here, and I'm at minefield right now. I'm gonna complete this optional thing here. Resupply and try to get closer to here because this will be the mothership Zeta. Ooh, damn! The mothership Zeta DLC, and that's my next goal in the SLP is to complete that. Ooh, oh, yeah! Watch out for these little babies. So we need to let me focus while this. We need to bring one of those back, which I have one of them, so that's fine. And we also need to get to the center. Enemies! Oh, I forgot how the galls. Nah, good old hunting. Good old sword. I think they're just rad roaches, so I don't have to worry about it. Keep on the lookout for anything good. I know there's some stuff here. Like I said, the botched recording covered this area, unfortunately, which means I have to redo it, but that's fine. I can hopefully do it quicker, do it easier. Ooh, pre-war book. Very limited in this game, not so much in New Vegas, which, as I'll reiterate my story of playing through New Vegas, starting off, I thought in the tutorial house, the doc fixes you up, spoilers alert. A doctor fixes you up from the event that happens in the very beginning of the game. And I saw like a whole shelf of pre-war books, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get like, this is one of those choices, ain't it? I'm gonna get a whole bunch of negative points, but I'm gonna get a whole bunch of money to start with, right? No, it just turns out they're super common in the game. Oh well, not in this game though. Aha! Grognak the Barbarian. Can I take the skates? Nice. They're not Heelys, so they're not as good as they could be. There's this. Oh wow, what a fierce one! I could drink from the water. Aha, I can sleep in the bed though, which I will do. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Just a quick glance around. You never know when you might find a rogue stimpak or whatnot, what have you. A shelf? No, that's a. That is a clock from the 50s. All right. Anything in here? Just casuals. Dressings. That looked like a grenade right there. That piece of rubble. See if I can get in here. Some decent loot. It's kind of good that I am starting redoing part of this. Because I kind of accidentally went to the Mothership Zeta with some stuff on me that made it difficult to continue because of carry weight. Nothing to worry about. Oh, a little lag there. Just the nature of the game, nature of the beast. And I do wanna. You're gonna hear some clicking from my mouse. Apologies. I do wanna get these mines. Oh! Yeah, from that. Because they do sell, and as well as. Oh, I'm getting sniped. As well as the fact that I get a little bit of XP from them. Not a whole bunch, but enough to make it somewhat worth my while. There's a house down here. What's that building over there? It looks like a big building. Yeah, it's a building, all right. I want to get in here very easy with a nice. Sometimes very easy ones don't even have the spot that moves, or the spot doesn't move. Or it's pre-war books and also raiders. Take your gear. So I am gonna go make a pit stop back to my base after this, most likely. Model of home, very hard. I need 100% to get that. I think that has a schematic of something in it. Of what? I am not sure. But tumblers today, though. Nothing there. It's always a good idea. Oh, sorry about that. Good idea to check the bathrooms in case of. Yeah, the food's not worth it. Weight versus health ratio is not good. I scratch my. Check the bathrooms in case there's a med box, medical station for. Ooh, for a Stimpak or two. Pre-war book, I'll take. I think there are 100 caps each, which is not that bad at this moment. Aha! Get a little Stimpak, Rad X. Don't need the blood pack. Could be useful, eventually. Nothing in here. There's three bathrooms in this place? It's kind of excessive, don't you think? Also, there's a bathroom here that the kid has to leave his room into the hall to walk down the hall into it. And there's no doors, so the parents are going to see it. Meanwhile, the parents have their own bathroom. Couldn't the kid just have his own bathroom? It's a little rude. No longer well rested, yeah, as to be expected. And just double check that I'm not fooling. Huh, guess this is the office, and the office has its own bathroom. That's weird. That is peculiar. Alright, keep the eye out for the mines. I wish they'd glow or something. Wish it'd be a perk that allows you to have them glow. Just bob and weave the sniper. Ooh. Benson. Oh, I can't get in there. Maybe. Oh. I didn't. Oh. Gosh. Oh, no. Explode already. Come on. Yeah, that sucker went boom, alright. Let's forget this guy. So I looked up details about this fella. Oh, nice crate. And there's a... Oh, bloody. Last time I recorded this, I was up there and it... That was... Oh no, just run. Panic mode. I panicked again. Let me, quick note. Why is it? My timer's weird. It's just like two marks. Oh, well, yeah, I guess that makes sense. Snipers usually means there's some kind of ammo box here. Probably on the top floor. Ooh, that's a bit of his leg. I'll take your sniper rifle, though. I don't really care for your outfit. Didn't need that. There you are, you beautiful boxes of ammo. Oof. He went out rough. His story is... He was actually a escapee slave. He escaped slavehood as a child. Came here... lured the raiders over here with promise of more people. And, ooh. And blasted them away. And ever since, he's been here, shooting anybody who got close enough. But now that I took him out, and the mines are gone, the legend of the minefield will be no more. I'm... Oh, legend killer. Also, bone breaker. I don't even know why I checked. There's never, like, anything good in there. Except for the one time there is. I think that's all the houses but that one. Yeah, there's one over there, I think. All the mines, though, so I will get in here. Haha, got a key. I don't have... Oh! Da-da-da, see the radio, gotta... there's a radio in here that I would like to turn off. Come on, there we go. Copywriting is a bitch. It is a rough and unkind mistress. And it will hit you hard if it hears a glimmer, a second. You give it a small opening and it pounces. That's why I don't put on the radio in this game, because all of it would be copyrighted. Every single song. Hello, Mr. Raider. I'll take your junk. Oh, hello, Wastelander. I won't take your junk. Clothing is not worth it. Speaking of that, value. Yeah, not worth it. I mean, I have the... Oh, a lunchbox. I have the spare to carry it, but I don't care. Aha! Another journal. Another journal. Oh, there probably was a safe in the other house I was in. Oh well. What is past is gone, and can never come to be. Or something. Who did I get that from, you may ask? I don't know. Someone probably made that quote. I have a habit of saying something extremely similar, as in, like, just a few words off, or exactly the same as somebody else, and having it be... But I have the habit of saying something very similar to an actual quote. Okay. It's like a superpower of mine. I can quote things without even knowing that the quote exists. I just say something and it's like, oh, wow, you watched that thing too, or you read this thing too. I'm like, huh? Nope. Like, oh, but you quoted it. I'm like, what are you talking about? And they're like, yeah, this. And they show me, I'm like, oh, huh, okay. Ooh, they got a bigger kitchen. They got a shelving unit for their rusty, janky-looking shelving unit for their dishes. I haven't seen anything like that for any other house, which is peculiar. Simple house design, though. Get behind it, I guess. Oh, no. I see. Oh, hello. That's not what I wanted, but I'll take it. See, his the bones are broken and brought upwards some to simulate a small child. That is unfortunate for you. Nothing, okay. Again with the double bathroom. Or I guess triple bathroom, maybe. I don't know, I didn't see. But the bathroom, they have one connected. The other one connected to the kids. It's silly. Is there a safe nearby? Hello? Maybe this is just not a safe. Oh. No? Alright. Sucks to be you, guys. Knock your plates. Boy, is it a shame. Oh well. Well, that covered about 1/4 of an episode. Can't get in that house, unfortunately. You should be able to get in that house. I could see you going in there through, like, the door or something. Oh. Mm-mm. Owie. Just want to double check. I think that's it. Three houses I checked, maybe. If I did, I did. And if I didn't, oh well. I am going to continue north just so slightly. I know where the, about where the thing is. About the, where the, waypoint, the point of no return. No, oh, you heard me press the buttons. It's because I'm standing and not crouching. Oh, there's mines everywhere still. Well, looks like the legend of the mine sweeper town will live on ever so slightly. For now, until it doesn't. I don't want to use a stim pack to run, but... Dang it. That was unnecessary. I won't heal the arm, though, because... Oh, hello. Oh! Oh, the animal perk. They're friendly-ish. I won't heal the arms because it's snowing outside. No, there's no reason to. Yeah, I get it. I'm crippled. All it does is impact my aim negatively, and well, I don't plan on shooting in the next few minutes. But of course, you never do in the wasteland. But oh boy, I'm sure something else will plan on shooting at me sometime soon. Yeah, I got time. I won't check that place out because that's a little big for me at the moment. But I'll check in here. These little stations. Is there? No, it's inside. These little stations usually have like schematics. Sometimes it's interesting. I'm planning on showing the plan off showing off schematic weapons later down the road. Nothing here. I'm taking another second or two. Slightly more of a focus time looking through this room because of this stuff over here. Okay, okay. That's a hard lock. That's a hard terminal. Can I get you? No, okay. Well, I'm gonna have to come back here, I guess. Got a new Qualcomm, so that's something, I guess. The quest... Ooh, hello. The quest involving the Nuka-Cola Quantums. It's not just like, hey, I'm the person with the quest, give me the Quantums now, and that's it. They actually say, you can actually, like, get information from them, like, hey, do you know where I can find some? And they direct you to a couple places where you can find a handful or two of them. Which is good, because, you know, you need, like, 30 of them? That's quite a bit. Alright, we're very close. I am going to make a couple saves here and there. Actually, this area, I'm going to get to this area right down here. Not get too close. I'm going to make a quick save right now. Keep making saves and rotating them, folks. Because right through these rocks, in that little area in there, behind the rocks, is the place of no return. And I would go activate the waypoint of it, but the fact is, it's not quite a waypoint. And if I activate it, it would be down cliffs. I'd have to go around to get back up to this thing. That's annoying. I know this place. I do know this place. I think there's a bobblehead here, but it's a special stat bobblehead, so it's not really a. I kind of don't want to take it. I will go inside the building if I can find it, just to show the bobblehead and show that I'm not lying. As I swim through the radiation sea here, yeah, there you are. Is that it? No, that's not it. Is that it? No, it's. Is it? I don't know. Maybe this is it. Maybe I should drink some of this. Oh! Hey, kind of spooked me there for a second. Yeah, he really did, a little rad roach. A little rapscallion. Are you dancing? Yeah, I can finish you off without this. I'll need aim to punch you. Well, kind of do, actually, but it's fine. Yeah, that'll teach her. It, him, whatever sexual preference the Red Roach wants to be. Do you sexually identify with the Red Roach? I don't. But if you do, good for you, I guess. Let's do some sick parkour. Back in this office, the back of office. Back to office? Back to office, back to reality. Oh, hello, Red Roaches. Goodbye, Rad Roaches. Critical. Oh, I crippled its leg. It's a Rad Roach, it's not gonna last long. Safe is. Oh, yeah, see? There's the agility bobblehead. Not gonna take it now. Wow, I can't believe. When I first saw the place outside, I was like, oh, this is definitely it. But as I saw more of it, I'm like, wait a second, things are a little off. Maybe this isn't it. Turns out, I was right. Yeah, I'm not gonna take the bobblehead, because I do want to get all my stats to 10. Ooh, is that an actual mine? Yeah, caps. I could sell it. I do want to get all the... God, these stupid things. All the... specials... Okay. I'm not gonna bother. All the special stats maxed out to 10. In order to do that, I need to get the level maxed first. I think it's 30. Yeah, because this game has 28 base levels, and the DLC Broken Steel adds another 10. Just let a Megaton heal up, lick our wounds, and then, well, then we'll be ready for the DLC. Take a little time, might be a bit of a short episode here, but next episode we'll definitely be starting the DLC areas, or at least that DLC area. Clinic. Oh yeah. Does she heal? No. I'm stumbling, I know. There is a part of her book that requires you to be hurt, and an optional objective is to have a crippled limb, and I might be able to do that now, actually, if I'm given the option.
How are those those hot little potatoes. Or whatever. You know what I mean. My very own landmine! Oh, just what I've always wanted. Well, always since I sent you out on this anyway. Now, tell me all about it. What was it like going through there? What's it like disarming a landmine? Not quite as much of a ghost town as they say, is it? Good work staying calm and collected under pressure. It'll be a great example for the book. I know you may not want to see any more explosives for a while, but obviously you know your way around them. Have a couple rainy day toys of mine. And looking at this landmine, it gives me an idea. It's a terrible device that does terrible things, of course, but it's easy to make your own, too. Yep, you've done a great job. I just need to add in the section on how to cook rat, and this chapter's done. Here, for your services, I've saved up quite a few stim packs. Of course, you may need them. We still've got two more chapters to go. The second chapter's going to be a bit trickier, I think. It'll cover how to handle creatures out there, for better or worse. For example, repelling mole rats, learning about mirelurks, and when all else fails, how to handle being injured. So let's buckle down and get to work on this chapter. What's first? Well, I never get to study anyone who's severely injured. Not without them crying to be fixed right away or trying to bleed out and all that. But obviously, you can handle a lot of abuse. So if I'm ever going to find a good example of human anatomy and injury resistance, it'd be you. Next time you get badly injured, return here so I can examine you before I heal you up. I mean, you're going to get yourself hurt anyway, right? Wow, what a great research assistant you are. I mean, really, that's dedication. Demonstrating how to withstand pain by getting injured? Wow. When you're ready, come back here with some serious injuries, maybe a crippled limb or two, and I'll take notes and fix you up. I'll be waiting here with plenty of bandages for you. So don't worry. Just go get horribly injured. Oh, and be careful. Well, how do you feel? Oh, I know it does, dear. But it's for a good cause. Try not to squirm so much while I take notes. Now, how would you describe the pain you're feeling? Any advice for how to keep it from being overwhelming? And remember, this is for posterity. That's a very enlightened attitude you've got. Shame it doesn't stop bullets, huh? Luckily, I'm here to patch you up. Now hold still and quit fidgeting. Ugh! How can you be walking around like this? Okay, I even stitched a little smiley face in you to keep up your spirits. It's kind of hard to see from your side, though. Here. Take this environment suit of mine. It will help with medical tasks, and it should help prevent the effects of exposure, too. There's a sort of mole rat repellent I've developed. I need it to be tested on a few mole rats before I can say it's a success. There's a lot we don't know about mirelurks and how intelligent and dangerous they are. That definitely deserves research. And that should be it for the second chapter. Which do you want to check out? Mole rats can burrow into almost anything and cause a lot of trouble. So I figured I'd make a chemical repellent stick for people to shoo them off. But I need it to be tested before I put the recipe to paper in the guide. So I need you to find some mole rats and test it out a bit. It'll be easy. One tap with the applicator and it overwhelms their senses with a sort of feel-bad sensation. Then they're gone before you know it. You could test it out on just a few mole ratties, but for real testing, Try it on 10 or more. There should be plenty in the tepid sewers downtown. Come.
After I do this one, which, I don't know, I might do it now. Actually, I need to console the elders and decide. But the Mylark one will be for another day, definitely. Even if I do the Mulgrats another day, the Mylark one is definitely one that I want to be a little careful about, because the side objective is to do... You implant a thing in the Mylark's lair, and the side objective is to not harm them. And in order to do that, you go there and wipe them out before you plant the thing. Yeah, it's a little odd, I know, but it's the best way to do it. Do I have a boop-boop? Bobblehead. Dump all my gear. I think I have some alright stuff that I want to keep. I'm going to throw that down in this too. That I'm going to keep one of those. Get rid of the Gauss rifle too. I know what's coming up for the... let's keep that too. For the DLC. And we are going to get new weapons. New DLC, new weapons. Kind of makes sense. I'll nuke colas and add all the quantums I have too. I can do this off screen, but oh!
I hope things are going well for you today, sir.
I'm just gonna leave. I'm gonna situate my equipment off screen and get back to you on the next episode. Oh, yeah, the Mylark ones. It's hilarious. She's like, oh, yeah, take care, go and talk to them and stuff, but don't, like, kill them or anything because I need the research and that's the side objective, so don't do it. And you're like, okay, I guess. So. You go there and kill all the Mylarks before. It's hilarious, actually. It's kind of funny. Kind of dumped it. We can keep those two. Those stealth boys might be good. Ooh, want to keep the 3 war books for sure. I should keep one of those. Vision battery. All the stuff has weight. And nice, down to 72 pounds. And counting with the pre-war books, boom, it's another 8 pounds. And the journal book thingies that I have, plus 2 medicine, melee, and, wait, yeah, melee and fisticuffs. And lockpicking. Unfortunately, the lockpicking one's not useful until you can get to at least 24, or at least increments of 25, so it's kind of but, quick episode. Just to kind of get the DLC preamble out of the way. Actually, hold on. I can't do this in here. Actually, I'll heal up. And we'll go and restore all reds. Give it a quick sleep. Give me that extra XP boost. It's temporary. And I didn't spend any perks or anything on it, so that's cool. But, you know, a little bit of extra XP. Just temporary. Just for a little bit of time. This small panic attack, looking at my mic, like, oh, is it muted, or? yeah, funny. Is my mic muted? Talking for half an hour to myself. Is it muted? I think I still have the mole rat stick, unfortunately, going into the DLC, but I'm going into it with much less weight than I did before. I have it, don't I? Yeah. Fortunately, that's 3 extra pounds I can't really get rid of. Oh boy, I know that. I have more than 3 pounds I can't get rid of as I touch my belly. Weight jokes. Weapons. Panic. Just what's a little panic among friends and mortal enemies and robots. There we go. Let me just do some some parkour. Yeah. I think there's no stamina thing in this game. So I just want to get to just want to get to the little waypoint over there. Now, I don't think I have anything else, any other affairs that I need to set in order before I go off to the mothership. What is this? This is a spaceship. Just a quick save. Yes. Yes it is.